Hey everybody, and welcome to MTV Cribs, where the M stands for monkey.
Yo dogs, I just wanna show off my crib to ya, give ya the grand tour of the Monkey Cave Treehouse. It's a beautiful thing, you guys are gonna be jealous. You're gonna be jealous of my amassed wealth.
Woo-hoo! Alright, as you can see here, I got the Snorlax, and he's wearing a Make America Great Again hat, because he's a true patriot. And behind him is a big old sheet that's covering up the window so I don't have to see the horrors of the outside world.
Sunlight, it burns.
Yo, that's my fucking Monkey Kingdom poster, movie poster. My favorite fucking movie, Monkey Kingdom. That's my wheelchair. It's Biggs' old wheelchair, but I took it back because it's mine. And now it's my desk chair because, needed a chair. So I use a wheelchair now. Ah! Oh, cribs!
All right, today we're gonna read some fucking edgy comments. At the end of the Walking Dead review, I said, let's do a fucking edgy comment contest. And you guys delivered! So let's read some of the ones that I chose. Real talk here, chat. I know this is ha-ha funny, our monkeys lol stuff to you, but this is actually a very serious subject. Donkey Kong is probably the most positive portrayal of black people I've ever seen in video games. He's strong, heroic, caring, but not afraid to get violent when someone tries to disturb the peace on Congo Bongo. I myself am black, and I've always looked up to Donkey Kong because he's a better role model to me than anyone else in my life has ever been. Kids would make fun of me at school when I ate bananas, or ruled like Donkey Kong, or threw barrels, or wore a red tie, but it didn't matter because Donkey Kong was all I had in my life. Without him, I'd be dead or a drug-addicted thug like my brothers. You know, it's weird that I started off with this one because it's not even edgy. That's just a beautiful story of a black urban youth who grew up with a great monkey role model. It's really inspiring. I don't know why I included it here in the edgy comment video.
This show is just a representation of America's consumer culture with the zombies simply being an allusion to Americans whose minds have been completely numbed by consumerism and Christianity. Maybe someday I'll take a shotgun and get rid of all the zombies at my high school and make the world a better place. Hashtag Ron Paul for president. Hashtag jet fuel can't melt steel beams. I killed my parents because they took my WoW account away from me. It was one of the most delightful experiences in my life. I love Linkin Park. Linkin Park. Everyone else just doesn't understand how good their music and lyrics are. Just throw it away. For this one, he just copy and pasted the opening pages of the Elliot Rodger Manifesto. Which, whether you like it or not, you've got to admit, it's one of the edgiest things ever written.
I came on mum. Sorry, dad.
Boy, I really like Hitler. I'm literally Sasuke. Cold, calculist, and with a terrible sense of humor. Sigh. Square. That's four edges right there. I'd like to see someone do better.
He's got a pretty good point. Nobody else has started posting shapes with edges on them. He might be in the lead so far. He's got four fucking edges. I didn't count any on the other ones.
My name's Izar, the Dark Clown. I'm 13 in 8th grade right now. Bisexual. I have self-diagnosed OCD, ADHD, autism, depression, anxiety, and I get bullied all the time. The only thing I have to save me from cutting myself is my favorite animes, Sword Art Online, Naruto, and Death Note. All the other kids at school think I'm weird, but really, I'm the kid who will make them pay for ever talking about me. My mom and dad finally got me that Death Note replica notebook on Amazon.com.
Every day after school, I write the name of the worst bully I have, whose name is Kevin. I hate Kevin so much. Once I made a voodoo doll of him, but it didn't work like usual. Why doesn't anything ever work for me? Oh no. I'm getting depressed again. I might cut myself tonight.
Every day I go to school and I get made fun of for wearing my full Pikachu onesie. It's not my fault they don't understand that I'm a pokesexual who only gets off to seeing Mareeps being fucked in the ass or Misty getting fucked by Muck. This comment is so edgy I can use it to cut myself to see how much it bleeds. It's like adrenaline, the pain is such a sudden rush for me. See, everything you say is real, and I respect you cause you tell it. My girlfriend is jealous cause I talk about you 24/7. But she don't know you like I know you, Mumkey. No one does. She don't know what it was like for people like us growing up. You gotta call me, man, I'll be the biggest fan you ever lose. Sincerely yours, Moji. P.S. We should be together too. Hitler did nothing wrong. He was just trying to be a hero we deserve but don't need. By killing every Jew, he wanted to stop those that would eventually lead the world to today. Armageddon of Muslims on Europe. He just couldn't pinpoint who exactly was behind this grand scheme, so he planned to kill them all for the greater good. Sadly, they took him for a mass murderer up to today, which is sad, tragic even, and unfair. Ask yourself this, are you living your life in a comfortable lie, or do you see the inconvenient truths for what they really are? Every country in modern day society uses some form of propaganda, especially global superpowers such as the US, Russia, Israel, and the UK, along with many others. I ask the question, what effect does US propaganda have on its own citizens and other people across the globe living under its influence? Topics I will be covering on this paper are war propaganda and spending as a whole, actions in the Middle East over the past 30 years to the present, and finally the attacks of 9/11 and conspiracy cover-up.
The actual first paragraph to my senior year research paper, thankfully my teacher was as much of a loon as I am. Well, holy fucking shit. It's pretty fucking edgy, and it's also one of the most cringeworthy things I've seen in my comments. And I've seen a lot of cringy shit, but this is like breaking the barrier of internet retardation, right? Because you actually submitted this as your senior thesis? it hurts!
I wish the Holocaust actually happened.
Now, what I like about this one is it's edgy in two different ways. One, he's claiming that the Holocaust didn't happen, which in many circles is considered edgy. But two, not only is he saying the Holocaust didn't happen, he's saying that he wished it did. As in, I wish all those Jews would have died. Top 2%! You're a fucking edge master. Good job. It's not a phase, Dad. God, you just don't understand me.
Not exactly an edgy comment, but I have a friend who's carved tattoos into his hand with a knife, listens to exclusively screamo death metal, and is elitist about musical taste. I just gotta say, screamo death metal is one of the cringiest genres of music that there has ever been. I can't take it seriously at all. And while he claims to be atheist, when he was struggling in his life, he literally looked up how to sell your soul to Satan and attempted it. All at the age of 16. Now, it sounds like 16 is quite the age for being an edgy retard.
This one is, cornflakes, you did it.
I used this smile to hide my pain, the pain I hold. When I was a child, around 14, I was taken backstage to a Linkin Park concert by a person who claimed to be their manager. Turns out, he was a rapist. He was also the Japanese voice actor for Shadow... He was also the Japanese voice actor for Shadow the Hedgehog. He took me out back and attempted to rape me. Right when he was about to penetrate me, I found a pair of broken scissors. I grabbed one of the blades and gouged his eyes out. The blood on the blade stick and it became red. Out of spite for him, I took his blood and streaked it on my black hair. When I came home, I found that my parents were where gone. Then I remembered. I never had parents to begin with. Until after sniffing the blade. The rapist was my father all along. So I took it upon myself to kill all the asshole fathers in the world as the floor body. For my body was always on the floor. But I kept failing because my humanity kept telling me not to. So I mostly sat around the house drawing OC commissions and finding black and red paint for my costume. The dumb government made the paint cost money, so I never had any paint. No, I just waited until the paints no longer cost money. Waited.
All right, guys, now's the part where I choose which comment was the edgiest! You're probably gonna be disappointed because there can only be one winner. So technically, I guess, per contest rules, everybody except for one guy will be disappointed. But hey, I mean, that's the risk of trying, right? You're gonna probably, 99% chance you're gonna fail. At least that's what I've learned in life. So the winner of the edgiest comment, I had to choose the absolute edgiest. The winner was Jordan, who just copy-pasted the Elliot Rodger Manifesto. I mean, I'm sorry, I know it's not original, but it doesn't get edgier than that. It really doesn't. That's the fucking, it's the pinnacle of edginess. You can't beat it. So because Jordan won, he gotta pick something for me to say at the end of this video. And let's just take a look at what he said. Columbine shooters Dylan Klebold and Eric Harris did nothing wrong.